What up? This is Rama Screen covering movies, TV, and entertainment, and here's my review of Netflix's new series, The One. Hey, before you watch my review, please subscribe to my channel, press that like button, and ring that bell so you can get notified whenever I post new videos. And if you would like to help support this channel, please do so at patreon.com/ramascreen. That's patreon.com/ramascreen. Let's rock this. First up, I would like to say thank you to Netflix for granting me the screener to this new show. They've asked me to not spill spoilers, therefore this review is spoiler-free. I repeat, there are no spoilers in this video review. Ah yes, here's another great Netflix show that hails from the UK. Now, the revelations here may not be as shocking as Behind Her Eyes, but The One is nothing short of juicy, addictive, and alluring. The only downside to it is that it's very, very slow. The relationship dilemmas can get painfully mundane and tedious, but each episode does leave you with an enticing cliffhanger that makes you want to see what ultimately lies underneath all those secrets. Based on John Marr's book, The One tackles a unique premise. What if we could find our perfect partner through DNA matching? Love and lies spiral when a DNA researcher helps discover a way to find true love and creates a bold new matchmaking service. Starring Hannah Ware. Okay, so there's gangster evil and there's corporate evil. And sometimes the line between the two can blur. In the case of Rebecca, however, a powerful, greedy CEO and owner of her revolutionary matchmaking company, the fly in her ointment, the monkey in her wrench, the pain in her ass, is not so much as rivals as it is more about the past catching up to her, and her constant, desperate effort to keep that hidden and buried. The thing is, she always stops short of going gangster evil. For those of us who are used to The Sopranos, for example, we tend to expect a certain outcome when it comes to getting rid of problems. Don't get me wrong, it still doesn't make her a good person. She's still ruthless by all accounts, but she's only teetering on the edge every time she applies threats or pressure. The show also has an interesting way of exploring the gender dynamics. It's so much fun watching Rebecca because there is an anti-hero side to her. She's not a full-on villain. She's more complicated than that. And Hannah Ware does a phenomenal job of capturing those nuances. Hannah exudes confidence and vulnerability at the same time. I have to be careful of what I say here, of course, so as to not give too many details away, because the story does have surprises around every corner. But there are basically three main plots happening, and they converge or cross paths in a very consequential way. It all stems from the idea that you don't have to go through the grueling process of dating or swiping left anymore, because your significant other has been decided by a DNA match, which essentially alleviates a lot of stress. Hey, you are my destiny. DNA has destined us to be together. But the supporting subplots illustrate what could potentially go wrong with this seemingly perfect concept. Turns out, when human feelings factor in, things get more profound than you expect. Granted, the show could do it much more efficiently and move things along more quickly. Sometimes it can get a little lost in its own process of developing the character's personal demons. But I still enjoy The One overall. It's thought-provoking, it's intriguing, and it's a very ravishing sci-fi crime drama.